Grandparents? Grandparents hate their kids. They will do anything for their grandkids. Let me tell you, I found that out real quick. You know, you start going over to your grandparents' house, there's no candy drawer at your house. Grandparents have a candy drawer.
I got candy drawer.
Grandparents don't cook at home. Might take a little longer to get there because they drive 15 miles an hour, but they're going to take you out to dinner every time you go there. You know? But one thing was a little odd. You start staying at the grandparents' house. You know, you get real comfortable. You're plotting how to kill your parents. They hate them. You hate them. But once you start going into a grandparent's bathroom, it's a little on edge. I'm 6 years old, staying at my grandparents' house. I got my toothbrush. I'm having a good time. I'm ready to go to sleep. I grab the white tube on the sink. Grandma's in her 70s. She, you know, the squeaky wheel's not getting the grease like it used to, so I don't know what vaginal moisturizer is. The next 2 days at school, I'm sitting there like a St. Bernard. School's coming out. I got a napkin jar. Cover it up, but, you know, stuff like that. And then Grandpa got sick. So, you know, apparently when grandparents get sick, they can't sit all the way down on the toilet. So you get that ring with the two bars on it. I thought they bought it for me. I didn't know he was sick. I'm in there doing L seats. Side dismounts off the thing. I thought it was parallel bars. I was having a good time. You know? The other thing that freaked me out, grandparents' menu. Because when you decide to stay over, they don't take you out for breakfast. You gotta eat breakfast at your grandparents' house. And they got a lot of things that taste pretty good. And when you're 6, 7 years old, you don't know what it's gonna do to your body. Prune juice. Kind of sweet, right? Looks like grape juice. Suck it down with some ice. Everything's good. Raisin bran. You love the raisins. You know nothing about bran. You just scoop it down with some sugar. Whole wheat toast. Yeah, exactly. You eat it all the time. So, you know, I decide I'm going to really be brave and I'm going to start staying at my grandparents' house during the week. And I'll go to school the next day from my grandparents' house, because it's right up the road. So I have a nutritious breakfast of whole wheat toast, prune juice. I even found a container that kind of looked like Tang. It had an orange label on it. Meta something. Orange flavored. And you know how kids make the lemonade? Not one scoop, not two scoops. Four or five. Not really tasting that good yet. So off I go to school. Everything's fine. Skipping up. Well, I wasn't really skipping. I was too fat. But I walk to school. I get in there. I got gym second period. Let me tell you something. Something's going on in here. I'm changing into my little boy shorts. You know, you got the gym teacher watching you, of course, because he's gay. And I get out there and they say, guess what we're going to do today? We're going to play dodgeball. As it starts gurgling. Oh, boy. Maybe I got to go to the bathroom, but game's about to start. About 5 minutes into the game, I'm against the wall, squeezing my cheeks together. I'm going to lose it. They start throwing the ball at me. I'm running back and forth on the wall like Jerry Lewis. Look like I got cerebral palsy or something. It's horrible. And then all of a sudden it happens. Dance volcano erupts. I got crap running down my legs. You know how it is. You've all crapped your pants in school, right? No? So you know what they do at that point, right? They shush you off to the corner. The gym teacher comes over. He says, I think you have a problem. You should probably go see the nurse. Oh, great, the nurse. Smells like a vet in there. Nurse is in that back room smoking a joint. She hates all the kids. So she comes out. What's the problem? Top half's white, bottom half's brown. What do you think? I just shit my pants. And I look over at the seat in the corner, and there's the nervous girl that puked on the bus. Right? You all know that girl. And what do they do when you puke on the bus? They take that shuffle bowl stuff from the bars and they throw it over the top, because that's going to make it smell better. Who the hell came up with that? So, of course, the nurse says, you get out your emergency card. Call your parents. And guess what? My mom works at BOCES, right? Yeah, they're going to let you go. My dad's an alcoholic. He's already down at Ray Renzo's on the corner, so I got no chance of getting home. So what do? They give you the half a roll of paper towels. You wipe up with enough dignity as you can, and then you know where they send you, right? No. You know what they have in the nurse's office? The box. You guys know the box, right? Anyone that's ever been sick knows what the box is. The box is under the nurse's desk, and it looks like the nurse may have raided a trailer park and stole every piece of clothing out of everyone's closet and just threw it in there. So, me being the size that I am, I'm wearing like eighth grade clothes and I'm in fourth, so I'm not really looking at something that's going to be too flattering to me. So I actually kept one of the outfits, and I'll show you guys now. Hey, Gary, can you hold the mic?
We'll start the bidding at 10.
Get your kids from fucking school when they get sick. So here I am, stinking like a pile of dog shit. Got this hot number on, and they're gonna send me back to class. So you can imagine when I dropped out of school. I mean, I'm like trying to suck it in. Pull it down a little bit, and then I figure maybe if I sit down, nobody will see it. Nah, it doesn't work. Anyway, I don't think the dollar store is going to take these clothes back tomorrow, but my name is Dan McRitchie. Thanks everybody for coming out. And if anybody wants to borrow this hot number, I'll have it open in a second.
Yeah! Dan McRitchie! Buddy. I can touch him? All right. Underneath?
Yeah.
All righty.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Men can lactate.
Food. They're going to close the kitchen down.
You just did it. We're running out of food. You heard him. The Commodore. He did not plunder enough in the last couple days. Jack Sparrow did not do enough work.